Subscribe to Marg Tutorial YouTube channel and press this bell icon so you can stay updated with latest videos. Hello friends, in this tutorial we will get to know that how you can set other detail in Marg ERP. With the help of this option, you can set other detail for any of your particular party. Means you can set special discount, item discount, free scheme credit and primary limit. Payment limit, bank rebate, credit days, collection days and collection day and so on options. So let's implement this in Marg software. For that, we will go to Masters menu, then Ledger Master, and from here enter on Modify Ledger. So Ledger Alteration window will be displayed in front of you, from where you will select that ledger of your particular party in which you want to set the other detail. So after selecting the ledger, we will press enter, and as you will press enter, ledger edit window will appear in front of you, from where we will enter on other detail option. So other detail window will be opened in front of you, where first field is note. Means you can set here any note, means any message for your customer. Like suppose this is our good customer, so we are giving him a 10% discount at the time of billing, or we want to give this much percent of discount or any special discount to our party. Or similarly, we want to give 10 plus 1 scheme to our customer. Means if you want to set any note or message for your customer, then you can type it here. Like here we will give the note, give special discount. So whenever we will create the bill of this party, that note will be displayed here. So let's see how this note will be shown at the time of creation of bill. For this, we will keep pressing enter or press page down key. Then we will come on main menu. Now we will create sale bill for this party. We will select the ledger for that party for whom we had set the note. So here you see the note which we had set for the party in other detail. So whatever note you will set for any party in other detail, that note will be shown as it is at the time of billing. Then we will press escape key and we will come on main menu. Again we will come on other detail, enter on the same ledger. So next is item discount percent. Means when any customer purchases any item from us, so we will give 3 or 5% or more discount on that purchase to that customer. So the discount which you want to give to this party, you will set here that discount. Suppose we want to give 5% discount to this party, so we will define here 5. Similarly, here we want to give 10 plus 1 scheme to this party, so we will define here 10 plus 1. Suppose now we will create a sale bill for this party and see, select an item, and here we will define quantity 10. So you will see, as we have defined 10 in quantity field, so the 10 plus 1 scheme which we had set in free scheme field of other detail, here in this sale bill software has automatically picked one item as free in free field. Means this party will get one item free along with 10 items. So now we will come to other detail. The next field is collection discount percent. Means how much discount you want to give to your party. Here you can set discount accordingly. Suppose here we will set 2%. After that, in credit days, we will define days, that how many days before party should pay the amount, so that this collection discount will be applied on it. And if party will pay the amount after the set days in credit days field, then this collection discount will not be applicable on this party. To know this option in detail, you can see our tutorial Party Collection Wise Discount. Next is Minimum Margin Percentage. In this, we can set that how much margin we are getting from this party. Suppose we want to get 5% margin from this party, so here we will define 5. After this is Breakage Expiry Discount Percentage. In other detail, discount means whenever you take any breakage expiry and return, then do you give discount on those products as well? If you actually give discount on that, then you will define that discount in this field. And if you don't give the discount, then you will skip this field. So here we will give discount like 3%. Next is volume discount percentage. Means if you want to give volume discount percent, then you will define it here. And to know about volume discount in detail, you can see our tutorial discount structure. Then is transport. Here you will define that transport name from where you will dispatch your goods. Like we mentioned here, Jaipur Golden Transport. Then is delivery by, means the goods which we are delivering from here are delivered in which mode of transport, via train, bus or by air. So define the mode here through which goods are getting delivered. Like here we will define by train. After that, next is bank name. Here we will mention that bank name through which we are receiving customer payment. Like we have given here Bank of Baroda. Then we will mention address of the bank in bank address field and branch in branch name. Next is new item. New item means suppose any new item is being launched in our company and we want that when we will do the billing of some of the customers for the first time, then the item which we have entered in new launch item, so that item should get automatically added in their bill for the first time. So for that, we will set yes to this field, else no. And to know about new item in detail, you can see our tutorial new launch item. After this, next option is invoice format, means bill format. You can see here default is set. Default means the standard format of Marg. If you want to keep the same, then let it be as default. But if you want to create party-wise invoice format, then enter on select here. So we will enter on select. Then next, we will select one format from DMP or GUI. There are two types of invoice formats in Marg software, that is DMP or GUI. Now suppose the invoice format which we had created for this, if it is in DMP format, so we will select DMP. As we will select here DMP, so invoice format which you have created from self format in DMP, that will be shown to you in this drop down, and whatever format you want to set here, that format you will select from here. Next is export. In export format, which are highlighted in drop down, Excel, standard, GST standard, Marg and self. Suppose your party Ahuja Medicine Center is using Marg software. So we will set Marg here. And if they are using any other software, then we will choose Excel format. And the use of standard and GST standard formats, such kind of standard companies like Cipla, Ranbaxy, etc. So these companies have their own standard bill formats. So if you want to export in standard format, then you will choose standard and GST standard accordingly. Next is self. Suppose we are using Marg software and this party is using any XYZ software. So our bill format and their bill format will be different. Suppose in my bill format, item name, quantity, rack, rate, MRP and many more fields are available, and in XYZ software, only 3 fields are available. That is item name, rate and MRP. So if we choose self, then according to their software, we have to choose bill format. And to know this option in detail, you may see our transaction import tutorial. Then next is bank rebate. Generally, use of bank rebate option is when any firm dispatch goods via transport, so then customer gets rebate on payment basis. For example, if they give payment in 10 days, then they will get rebate of 3%. Similarly, if they pay in 15 days, then rebate of 5% is there. Means you can set two conditions. That is, if this party will pay in 10 days, then set 3% here. And if in 15 days, then set 5% here. So in this way, you can set these two conditions. Next is credit days, means for how many days this party can purchase goods in credit. Suppose we will define here 15 days. So if this party will not do payment in 15 days, then interest will be charged from them. So you have to mention the rate of interest in interest field, which you will be charging from them. Suppose if this party will not do payment in 15 days, then they will be charged for 20%. So we will define here 20. Then next is items, means our customer Ahuja Medicine Center. Whenever the bill is being created for them, so in the bill, not more than 3 items must be added. So we will mention 3 here and save it by pressing page down key. Now we will generate bill for Ahuja Medicine Center. Suppose first item we will take is acne derm lot, then second item and then third. And now as we will press enter to buy fourth item after the third item, software will show this message to you. Line limit 3, total line 3, accept yes or no. Because as we have seen, we had set 3 in an item field of other detail, so that whenever we will create an item for this party, not more than 3 items will be added in it. So as you can see on the screen, after adding the 3 items, we will press enter. Then software will show this alert message. So for now, we will press Y to accept it. Then press escape key and come to the main menu. After this, next is sales rate. Sale rate means on which rate you will sell to this party. A rate, B rate, C rate, D rate, etc. From here, you are required to set that on which rate you will sell to your party. Now suppose we have created 3 parties in which we have set rate A, rate B and rate C. Rate A is for retailer, rate B is for distributors and rate C is for stockist. So the party for whom we are setting other detail. If this party is a retailer, then we will select in sale rate, rate A. And if this party is a distributor, then we will select rate B. And if it is a stockist, then rate C. So for now, we will select rate A. Then is P batch. P batch means print batch. It means when you take a printout of this party bill and you want that bill of the product should be printed on batch. So set yes here. And if you don't want that batch should get printed, then set no here. For now, we will set yes here. Then is breakage expiry rate. It means, suppose we have sold few products to these customers and those products are being returned by the customers due to some breakage and expiry. So when these products came to us, then we have returned those products on which rate? MRP, default and on cost, etc. MRP means the MRP of products. Default means that rate on which you sold the products. So according to you, you can select the rate whichever you want to choose. So for now, we will select MRP here. Then is primary limit. Suppose we will set the limit for this customer 12,000. Means this party cannot borrow goods from us of more than 12,000. But suppose if this party faces any problem and says to pay later. So in that case, we can increase the primary limit from 12,000 to 15,000 for this party. In this way, if you want to create limit bill wise, then you can specify number of bills. Suppose we want that this party cannot take goods on credit after the 5 bills. So here we will define 5. And similarly, we can mention days in days here that for how many days you want to give primary limit to this party. And here in drop down, you will see 2 fields are shown to you, manual set and auto set. So you can set accordingly that you want to set primary limit for this party while making the manual bill, or software should automatically applied as primary limit gets finished. Then next is credit limit. Credit limit means that up to which amount a customer can borrow goods from us. Now suppose we have set the credit limit of 15,000 for this party. Means now this party can borrow goods up to rupees 15,000 from us. But if you want to specify it according to the bill that this party cannot take credit more than 5 bills, so for that you will define the number of bills here. Suppose here we will set 5, and similarly in days we will mention days that for how many days you want to give credit limit to this party. Suppose here we will give 10 days. Then here in drop down you will be shown 3 options. Only indicate, follow strictly and stop billing. Only indicate means if you will set only indicate for this party, then when you will create the bill, then software could indicate you that credit limit is finished. If you want to continue the billing, then you will do OK to the indication window and continue the billing for this party. After this, next is follow strictly. It means when party limit gets finished, then software will not allow to create the bill. Next is stop billing. Means if we will set stop billing as the credit limit gets finished, then software will not allow you to do the billing of this party. And to know credit limit and primary limit in detail, you can see our tutorial credit limit management. Next is ledger category. In this, you will set that the party named Ahuja Medicine Center. This is retailer, stockist, distributors or other. Means, whatever is the ledger type of your party that you can set from here. After this, next is rate plus minus percent. This option means that when we will do the billing of this party, then software will add 5% in its actual amount. So we will set here 5. So when we will do the billing of its party, software will add 5% in its actual amount. Similarly, if you want that software should minus 5%. So for that, we will set minus 5. For now, we will set plus 5 because we want that whenever we will do the billing of this party, 5% should automatically get added in it. After this, next is type. You can see in below, some criteria or the calculation has been defined of type field. Means on which formula you want to apply the percentage which you had set in rate plus minus field that you can check from the below and set for this party. Means whatever is the calculation of A, calculation of B and so on. By default, this field is set on A. Basically, A means rate equals to rate plus rate percent. Means, suppose if you have set minus 5 in rate plus minus field. So this much percentage will be minus from the party's actual amount. And if you have mentioned in plus, then it will be added in the bill that you can set here according to your party. So now we had set plus 5 in rate plus minus field. So we will set A in type field. After this is collection days. Means on which days you want to take collection from this party. Now suppose this party has said that they can give collection from Monday to Friday only. Saturday and Sunday is not possible. So for those days, set N and for other fields, set Y. Next is collection day. Means on which days we can take collection from this party. Now suppose this party has given us few days to take collection, like we can take collection from this party in 10, 15, 20 or 25 days. So accordingly, we will define here. Next is margin. Suppose our MR or salesman will go to this party for collection. So MR keeps margin and return. So you will mention the amount of margin here, which is kept by MR. Then next is payment limit. It means that this party has given us a limit that this party can only give payment up to this limit only. Suppose this party can give the payment up to 25,000. So we will set 25,000 in this field. And if you want, then you can define the payment in percentage as well. Then is upload password. Means if you want to generate any password that the details set by you for your party cannot be changed. Nobody can do any kind of changes in other detail of this party's ledger. So for this, you can set password according to you. Then is party type. Means from here, you can set that your party is local or central. And if you want that software should ask you the type at the time of bill generation, then you can set it here as well. Next is purchase under, where you will set yes or no for local purchase. As you know, there are two types of purchase, local and central. Now suppose we are in Delhi and doing sale in Delhi, then this sale will be called as local sale. And if we do sale out of Delhi, like from Delhi to UP, Delhi to Maharashtra, then it will be called as central. Similarly, this is applicable in local purchase and central purchase and in purchase under as well. So if you will do it local purchase, then set yes to it, otherwise no. In the same way, if you will do local sale, then set yes, otherwise no. So friends, in this tutorial, we have learned that how you can set other detail in Marg ERP. Thanks for watching.